Welcome to Love Bite.
Wife is planning to leave me, left me for my best friend, and they've already started trying to get pregnant. I guess I should call him my former best friend at this point, but it's hard to accept that it's all gone just like that. You spend so many years with a person building a relationship, and one day it all turns to dust. I've known him since high school, 15 years ago. He was like a brother to me and like a son to my parents. When we were younger, we were at each other's houses all the time. He was always coming with my family on trips, and I did the same with his family. We've done so much together. He was the best man at my wedding, and I would have been the best man at his wedding. Many trips and nights were spent together. Many times we helped each other. Many conversations about life, love, and ourselves. He was always my go-to person in tight situations and when I needed advice. It's hard to say how much losing him hurts, because whatever else he is, he was always there for me when I needed him and a solid source of advice. He was a true friend until he wasn't. It may be as big of a blow to lose him as losing my wife. I've been married to my wife for almost 5 years, but we've been together for 7. I remember when we first met. Love at first sight. She was gorgeous, had these really piercing blue eyes, and had a really infectious laugh. We hit it off, and to my surprise, she accepted when I asked her out, even though I felt like she was out of my league. I fell even more in love with her as we got to know each other. She had such a passion for life and helping people. She was so kind and gentle with everyone, just a really warm person, and that made me love her more. I loved being married to her, and I always felt our marriage was great. Not even just good. I was not one of those husbands who let himself go. I took care of myself and ate well. I remembered all of our anniversaries and special dates. When she talked to me, I listened and paid attention. I took an interest in her life genuinely because I loved her and it was important to me, but I also gave her space and avoided being too needy or clingy. I made sure to do my part around the house. I cleaned as much as she did. Our sexual life was great as far as I could tell. I did my best to love her, care for her the way a husband should, and show her she was appreciated. I tried my best to keep dating her after we married. I can say without any doubt that I never took her for granted. I don't know what else I could have done. I have asked myself that over and over again, and I still don't know. I wonder if I did too much. Did she think I was too much of a pushover? Did she not respect me? I'm not saying our marriage was perfect. We did have arguments, but they were never major ones. The trouble started when my best friend broke up with his girlfriend. He was pretty upset about it and took it hard. I talked to him, but my wife asked me one day if I cared if she went out for a coffee with him to talk and give him a woman's view or opinion. I told her that was fine with me. She and my best friend were also friends. We'd done couples trips with my friend and his girlfriend, and she'd also hung out with him tons because he was around me so much. I didn't think anything of it because their relationship never seemed inappropriate. I do remember him saying I was lucky and she was attractive when we first started dating and when I married her, but there were no inappropriate jokes or anything like that. My wife might have said he was handsome at some point, but that was it. I saw no red flags, and even after thinking about it more, I still don't see any. I never saw anything, which made me think there was every chance of them being more than friends. When my wife came back from coffee, she seemed a bit off. She was really angry with his ex and said that he deserved better. I remember telling her something like, "He's young and he'll mend in time," and she seemed very upset by this. She said that he needed time and that whatever girl ended up with him would be very lucky, and his ex was a fool to leave him. I may be misremembering parts of that conversation, but that was the basic gist. She was very sparse on details and very vague, but it didn't seem weird to me at that time. It seemed like she was being protective in the same way I would be protective of him as my friend. Her behavior started getting stranger after that night. She wasn't doing anything really overt or suspicious, but she was vague about what she was doing. She would say that she's going to see one of her friends or run an errand, stuff like that. I'm not a controlling person, and she'd never given me a reason to doubt her, so I didn't make an issue out of it. And really, at that time, I didn't find it so strange. I noticed my friend was being weird too, but I thought it was because of his split and him being depressed. I would invite him to hang out, and he'd turn me down, which was unusual. He never had a reason other than that he was busy. I started seeing less and less of him, and when I did see him, he was different. I would not say nervous, but I definitely seemed not to be comfortable. He sent me a message asking me to stop by his house one day. He said we needed to talk about some things, and he had to get some stuff off his chest. I drove over there, not suspecting anything. I knocked on the door and he came to answer. I tried to make some jokes and have a light conversation, and he completely ignored me. He asked me to go into the living room, and there was my wife sitting on his couch. I don't know if I knew at that moment, but I did feel a sense of dread start to come over me. She started crying almost as soon as I walked in, and he jumped right in and told me that there was no easy way to say what he was about to say, but he and my wife were in love and wanted to be together. I stood there, completely stunned. I felt like I wasn't even alive for a while. When I started to come back to my senses, they both tried to say how sorry they were and that they both loved me and regretted it happening. They told me that this just happened, and they never intended for things to turn out like this. They knew they were wrong, but it didn't matter because they were in love. They both promised that they had not had sex and that it was only an emotional affair. I'm not sure if that is true or not, but I don't know if it really matters. And that is basically where we are now. Since that day, I've gotten more texts from them apologizing and ones from my wife asking if I'm okay and telling me she's here for me and still cares for me. But I mostly ignore them. They aren't as frequent anymore either. She decided to move out of our house. I didn't ask her where she was going, but a friend of mine told me that she moved in with my former friend as soon as she left. That was only a few months ago. She stopped by the house a few days ago to pick up some things. I tried to avoid her, but then she asked me if I had a second. She told me that she and my former friend are trying to get pregnant. She wanted to give me a heads up so that we could deal with it as we went through our divorce. She also wanted to tell me personally because she felt like I deserved to know and hear it from her. It hurt so much to hear how she's already moving on. We wanted to have children together, but she wanted to wait until she turned 30. Now he's going to get to be the father of her children, and I'm going to have to watch her carry his child. I am here looking for any advice you can give me. I don't know how to deal with her getting pregnant. I feel like that's going to be a struggle and a source of pain once it happens. I feel so jealous of him because he is getting the life I wanted with her. I also know that her getting pregnant is really the end. Once that happens, there's no chance we can reconcile. I have considered asking her to try counseling, but I haven't because I doubt she would be interested since she wants him and a life together with him. I also don't know how to process all of this. I don't know how they could both do something like this or how I could not see it. I don't understand why she left when we were happy. I feel like I don't believe in anything anymore. If you can't trust your wife and best friend and a marriage doesn't last with as much effort as I put in, then nothing is real and life is all one big lie. Life just isn't fair sometimes.